Louis Pasteur's swan neck flask experiment in 1859 showed that microbes needed to be present for decay to occur. Pasteur placed nutrient broth in long neck flasks, then bent some of the necks into an S shape, hence the name swan neck. The broth was boiled, killing any microbes that may have been present. Then he allowed the flasks with the sterile broth to sit undisturbed. Pasteur found that the broth in the normal neck flask became cloudy and was found to contain microbes such as bacteria and mould. The broth in the swan neck flask did not change, as particles in the air were prevented from landing on the broth due to the shape of the flask neck. This showed that microbes don't appear due to spontaneous generation. Instead, they entered the flask with the air on dust and other particles and multiplied in the broth. The aim of this investigation is to model Pasteur's experiment. Before starting, complete a risk assessment of the investigation. Chicken stock will be used as the nutrient broth, and conical flasks will be used as the vessels. Pour 250 ml of chicken stock into each of the flasks. Each of the flasks will be boiled for 15 minutes to destroy any microbes that may be present in the stock. Seal two of the flasks with stoppers to model Pasteur's swan neck flask that prevented airborne particles from entering. Leave the other two flasks open to the air. Write a description of the contents of the flasks. The flasks are placed in an area where they can remain undisturbed for a number of days. Like all models, this investigation has its limitations. Pasteur's swan neck flask still allowed for the passage of air, whereas our flasks are stoppered to prevent air from entering. In this investigation, the independent variable is access to the air, which may contain microbes. The dependent variable is microbial growth in the form of colour change and clarity of the stock. Variables that have been controlled are the same type and amount of stock is used in each flask, the flasks are boiled for the same length of time, and the flasks are left undisturbed in the same area. The flasks were left to stand undisturbed for a number of days. When we examine the flasks, we can see the stock in the flasks that were open to the airborne particles have become cloudy when compared to the stock in the flask that was stoppered. This indicates the presence of microbes and can be confirmed by plating out some of the cloudy stock on agar plates. Describe the results in the table. Since both flasks were boiled, the microbial growth in the stock of the open flasks must have been caused by microbes that entered the flasks after the boiling process. Thus, microbes must have entered the flasks from the environment. The results obtained by modelling Pasteur's experiment support his theory that microbes were needed for decay. Pasteur's experiment was repeated multiple times by many scientists, and each time the results were similar, supporting the germ theory of disease. Pasteur demonstrated the link between germs, decay, and disease, and showed that microbes were not the product of disease and decay, but rather the cause.